Good morning, guys. Well, today I've got a new problem. This is a 2000 Suburban. You've seen me working on it in the past. I've got a low volume coolant leak over the last few months, and basically what I've been doing is I've been adding about a liter of distilled water every couple of weeks to the coolant reservoir, even though I've not had any evidence of coolant disappearance or coolant on the driveway. And so today I'm going to be pressure testing the system to try and make a decision as to what the diagnosis is. Now, in the past, I've changed the water pump in this truck twice, the last time about 5 years ago, and I've changed the radiator twice, the last time about 8 or 9 years ago, and there doesn't seem to be any evidence of fluid leakage either out of the weep hole or from the radiator in any place. And so I'm going to look at it more closely by pressure testing the system and seeing what we see. I hope you come along. So the idea behind these pressure tests is to put the pressure onto the system. Now, this is a radiator capless system. The radiator cap is actually right on the top of the reservoir, and in that context we adapt it, and I've got an adapter kicked, Astro number 7858 as I recall, and with some difficulty adapter number 10 seems to fit. I've had to plug off the vent hole as well, and I've pressurized it to 15 psi and it seems to be holding there nicely. So now we're going to wait a few minutes and see if we can see water dripping under pressure. Of course, the thing to do here is to walk around underneath and see if you can find some wetness, and I've spent about 15 minutes doing that, and I think I've found a clue that's going to lead to the problem. Now, if you look here, you can see the wetness down there. And when I was looking at that, my first instinct was that it was wet because of a leak between the water pump and the engine. But in fact, if you look closely, you'll see that water is actually dripping down onto it from above. So now I'm looking down into the gap between the alternator and the intake manifold, the throttle body, and I suddenly caught a drip right there. If you just watch it carefully, you'll find a little drip every once in a while. There, did you see that? So let's take off some of the intake first. This is an 8mm nut driver. I'm going to undo this clamp and this clamp right here, and we'll pull the thing right off. I'm so pleased to find this. My initial concern was this is an early head gasket leak, but clearly we're dripping from just the end of a hose right there. Do you see it? Let me take you underneath with a little GoPro camera. You can see there are two coolant hose connections under the throttle body. The leaking one is on our left. That one goes to a midpoint in the radiator, and the hose on our right leads to the top of the engine block. With a slow leak, the coolant drips onto the water pump and evaporates away before it has a chance to make a puddle on your driveway. I've seen a coolant leak here in Chev trucks before. It's worth checking out if you've got unexplained loss of coolant, especially if you're suspicious of the water pump gasket. These hose connections at the throttle body aren't even mentioned in the dealer repair manual. I assume they're there to allow trapped air pockets a shortcut pathway back to the radiator, but I don't know. Because the fluid is not hot, I haven't run this car in a couple of days. I'm just going to decompress it here and we'll see what happens. We're a little bit low on fluid, and that's why we're not leaking fluid. You can see there's a little bit of fluid leaking out even so. I'm just going to cut it off here. We've got some extra room. Of course, the other option is just to replace the hose. I don't have a replacement on hand at the moment. And this is draining a bit more than I thought it would, so I'm going to quickly put it back on. I'm going to use a little of my silicone paste to help it go on easily. So at the end of it, don't forget to burp the system. Basically, just run the engine with the radiator cap off for a short while to allow any bubbles to disgorge and clear the system of air bubbles so you don't overheat. As far as why the throttle body has two coolant tubes leading to it, I'm not really sure. I'm wondering if it might be an issue with burping, or perhaps an issue of cooling some of the sensors down so they perform correctly. I don't really know. I'd be interested in what other people have to say. So if this video helped you out and you want to see more of them, then hit like or subscribe or leave a comment. I'd love to hear what others say. Thanks for watching.